Hi friends, welcome back to my channel and welcome back to another collab video. This one is hosted by Joan at Joan's Pointed Plates and Amanda, my friend, at Amanda Lewis. Definitely check out both of their channels. They have fantastic WW content. Also down in the description box is all of the other channels participating in this collab. So when you walk away from these videos, you are going to have a arsenal of breakfast and brunch recipe ideas. So make sure you check out everybody else down in the description box and definitely let them know that I sent you if you go over to visit any of them, and especially Joan and Amanda. So today's recipe that I am bringing to you is so incredibly delicious, absolutely positively delicious, and it is a great breakfast or brunch or just a snack idea. So if you wanna see what I'm bringing to you for today's collab, all you have to do is stay tuned. I'm going to be making a scone, and this is a perfect meal for either breakfast or brunch. The recipe comes courtesy of WW Pound Dropper. Make sure you check out her blog. She has fabulous Weight Watcher recipes. So today we'll be making a blueberry lemon scone. I cannot wait. I am a scone lover, and they are so high in points. And wait until you see the point value of these scones. So let me show you what is in our lemon blueberry scones. First, you're going to need some skim milk. So I'm going to go ahead and use this Fairlife. You're also going to need the Devotion Nutrition, and this is the Angel Food Cake protein powder. This is the best protein powder on the market, not only for drinking, but especially for baking, because it is sugar-free, it has MCT, it's gluten-free, and it is bloat-free, which is super important when it comes to protein powder. You don't want the kind that make you all bloated. So Devotion is amazing. They have both the Angel Food Cake, which is what we're using in this recipe, and they also have brownie batter, which is their version of a chocolate protein powder. So if you're interested in Devotion, I do have a 10% off discount code that I'd love to share with you. So in the description box, go ahead and click the link and enter the code here on the screen to save 10%. Make sure you click the link first so it recognizes you're coming over, and my code will then be valid. Highly recommend Devotion. Again, best protein powder there is. You're also going to need some self-rising flour, a sweetener alternative. So I'm going to go ahead and use this monk fruit. I really like this sweetener. I buy this off of Amazon, and it is linked down in my Amazon store below. You'll also need some blueberries, and you can do fresh or frozen, some ground cinnamon, an egg, some light butter, and some lemon extract. So let's get started on our scones. So to get started on our scones, you're gonna need to grab out a large bowl. To that bowl, you're going to add 3/4 cup of self-rising flour. You're also going to add 1 scoop of the Devotion Nutrition protein powder. So make sure you get a nice level scoop of that. You're also going to add in approximately 1 teaspoon of ground cinnamon and 2 tablespoons of your sweetener. So this is the monk fruit. And then I'm just going to give this a quick stir together to make sure everything gets nice and incorporated. And then we're going to put our wet ingredients into a separate bowl and add it to this one. Next, we're going to mix together our wet ingredients. So we have 3/4 cup of skim milk, and we have 1 egg and our lemon extract, and we want about 1/2 teaspoon of lemon extract. And then we're just gonna whisk this together and set it aside, and we'll be ready to add it in with our dry ingredients. Next, you're gonna take your 5 tablespoons of, I can't believe it's not butter, and you're gonna go ahead and just kind of cut that in with your flour. So you just wanna make sure that you're breaking up your butter into smaller chunks, and then just kind of mixing it in with your flour. Get that nice kind of crumbly texture out of the flour, and then we'll add in our wet ingredients and our blueberries. Once you have that nice crumb look to your flour, we're gonna go ahead and add in our wet ingredients. And we're gonna fold that all together, get that nice and combined. And then lastly is our blueberries before this goes into the oven. And let me just tell you, this smells so good. It has that sweet, but also that kick of that vibrant lemon. So I am very excited. I love lemon anything. And as you know, I love blueberries. So this is going to be delish. So there is our mixture. And then you're gonna go ahead and take your blueberries and you want approximately 3/4 cup. So I'm just gonna kind of wing it. I don't mind having a little bit of extra blueberry. I'm not gonna be mad about that at all. I did rinse these and these have just been sitting on my counter drying. So go ahead and add in your blueberries and then you wanna just really gently fold those in. You don't wanna overmix your batter. And then we're gonna go ahead and add this to our greased pan and get this into the oven. But look at how delicious this looks. Next, we're going to spray a round baking sheet with just a little bit of nonstick cooking spray. And then we are going to add our scone mixture into our baking dish. And this is going to go into the oven at 400 degrees until it is completely cooked through. So it should probably be 15, 20 minutes or so. Make sure you're able to insert a toothpick and it comes out clean. And that's how you know that it's nice and perfectly done. So I'm just gonna kind of spread my mixture very gently into the bottom of my pan. And you guys, look at this. This looks so delicious. So I'm gonna pop this in the oven and I'll be back to show you the completed lemon blueberry scones. I just pulled the scones out of the oven. You guys, look at how delicious these look. They fluffed up. They look incredible. So I'm going to let them cool and then we're gonna whisk together a super quick glaze and we'll add that to the top of our scone and then I'll plate it up and show you the serving size and give you the smart points. But this is so, I'm so excited. For the icing or the glaze for our scones, I'm going to be using this Sucrin icing. This stuff is really good. You can get this on Amazon. I do have it linked down in my description box below. I love it. It does not have the cooling effect that Swerve has. So in my opinion, it's a much better alternative to powdered sugar. Our scones are nice and cooled. Look at that deliciousness. So what I have here is 1/4 cup of the Sucrin icing. And then I just have a little water here and I'm just going to add it and mix until I have the consistency of glaze that I want. And I want this to be liquidy enough that I can kind of drizzle it over the top of my scone. So that's actually looking pretty good. So see how it's a little more of a liquid consistency. So I'm gonna get this nice and mixed together and then we'll just drizzle this over the top of our scones. So go ahead and take your powdered sugar mixture and we're just going to kind of just drizzle it evenly over the top. We wanna make sure that we do have a little bit of glaze on all of our pieces. And this glaze or this powdered sugar alternative is 0 points, it's 0 calorie. So this isn't gonna add any extra points. It's just going to give that nice, delicious, frosted scone from the bakery vibe to our scones. So I'm gonna add all of this and I'm gonna let this dry or continue to cool for a few more minutes before we slice it up because I'd like the scones to be nice and cooled and also that glaze a little bit hardened. But look how delicious that looks. So here are our completed scones. You're gonna go ahead and cut them into 8 equal servings. So that's quite a large slice with frosting. And these scones for 1/8 is only 3 smart points. So you can have a blueberry lemon scone with frosting for 3 smart points. So I'm gonna go ahead and plate this up and I'll be back to show you exactly what 1 serving size looks like. But I am thrilled with this recipe. It is perfect for breakfast, lunch, or just even a snack. So here's 1 slice of the scone. Oh my gosh, that is a huge slice for 3 points. You guys, this looks so incredibly delicious. So what a perfect, perfect, delicious, delicious breakfast. Thank you for joining me on another collab video. These scones were delicious, like absolutely amazing. My husband loved them. Highly, highly recommend that you try these. These would be nice for breakfast. Pair them with some eggs, some turkey bacon, and you have a low point delicious breakfast. So if you're new to my channel and you came over from one of the other channels, please let me know who sent you so that I can give them a big thank you. If you go visit one of the other channels in the collab, let them know that you came from my channel and you are part of my YouTube friends and family. So make sure you subscribe. Hit that bell so you're notified every time that I upload. You don't want to miss a single video. Give this one a thumbs up. Comment down below. Let me know what you thought of this recipe and if you're going to give it a try. Thank you again to Joan and Amanda for hosting, and I'll see you guys all in the next video. Bye.